Father, we bless you. Teach us your word in the name of Jesus. This is the ministry of Moses, part 10. And we're going to take our text from Exodus chapter 10, from verse 1 to 15. The ministry of Moses, part 10. How did God harden Pharaoh's heart? Why did God actually harden the heart of Pharaoh? No, the answer is in Exodus chapter 10 from verse 1 to 2. 1. So that the Lord can show his signs before him. And 2. The Lord wanted what he would do in Egypt to become an event that will be told from generations to generations. Things don't just happen. They happen for a reason. The servants of God, went to Pharaoh at the palace and told him that if he refused to let go of the Israelites, that the Lord will send locusts into the Egyptian coast. The Lord said, these locusts will cover the ground in such a way that hardly will they see the sand on it. What is locust? Locust is a type of grasshopper that is very destructive to crops and other vegetation. This means that by sending locusts, their economy will be affected again. When God wants to wipe out a nation, the first sign is that their economy will be under attack. Remember in the previous chapter, the Lord sent lice into Egypt. What is a lice? What is lice? Lice is, they are small parasitic wingless insects that can attack the body of a person or an animal. This one was also an attack on their economy because it affected both the people and the animals, which is to them a means of transport. Immediately Moses had spoken to Pharaoh, he turned himself and went out of the palace. Another lesson to learn here is that Moses was not enticed by the wealth of Pharaoh. I know many times after Pharaoh had seen some wonderful things that his own magicians could not do, being done by Moses, he will try to offer them money, but the man will refuse. Many times the king's servant will want to offer them food and drink, but they will still say no. You may not last in ministry if you have not learned how to say no to some good things. I don't mean bad things. I mean saying no to some good things. That it is good does not mean you must have it. Many eat poison because of their inability to discern. Pharaoh's palace is not a place to eat and drink or even collect something. It is a place of warfare. Your hand should not, your hand should hold the sword and not their sweet potatoes. You should fight and not feast. Many fail to realize that they are in Pharaoh's palace. So they feast instead of fighting, and they end up becoming a prey to life predators. Let us consider verse 7. And Pharaoh's servant said unto him, how long shall this man be a snare unto us? Let the men go, that they may serve their God. Knowest thou not yet that Egypt is destroyed? When Moses left the presence of Pharaoh, he didn't say anything. It was this reaction from the king that made his servant advise him that it is better he let the Israelites go. I think some of those that was with him, that were with him, were business experts, because they showed him the graph of Egypt's economy since the day he had refused to let them go. How that their currency is now losing value when compared to other nations' currency. So they concluded by saying this to the king. Are you not aware that Egypt is being destroyed? So with this analysis, Pharaoh called on Moses and Aaron, you know, and Aaron, trying to consider their demands. Before we go into that, still in verse 7, the first question the wise men asked, you know, the first question the wise men that counseled Pharaoh asked was, how long shall this man be a snare unto us? This means that Moses became a snare to a whole nation. That is what God wants us to be to our enemies. He does not want our enemies to be a snare unto us, but that we should be a snare unto them. A snare is like a trap. It is something that when you fall into it, you will surely feel the effect. In verse 8, the king asks to know those that will go with Moses. Then he told him that every one of the Israelites will leave that land, both male and female, young and old, and even with their belongings. When the king heard this, he was not pleased, so he objected to that request. In verse 11, it was recorded that they were driven out of the king's, they were driven out of the king's presence. Immediately, God spoke to Moses. He asked him to stretch his hand over the land of Egypt, that the locust may appear. Can see that in verse 12. But in verse 13, the Bible recorded that Moses stretched forth his rod. This would mean that Moses' hand have become the rod of God. What the rod of God will do if stretched is what his hand will do if stretched. The Bible said, the kind of locust that can come up, you know, the kind of locust that came up was unimaginable. It has never happened before and will never happen again. It means that there are some wonders the Lord did in Egypt then that is one time, you know, that is once and for all. There are some wonders that God specially designed for Egypt that you can never see it happen anywhere, not then and not tomorrow. So it is specially designed. Those things we see happening to Egypt, God specially designed it for them. There are some of those wonders God performed in Egypt that has never happened before and that will never happen again. Now, since those doings have never been heard and will never be heard, then it means that it will forever be remembered in Egypt. They will say it from generations to generation. Even when a new Pharaoh comes up, he will be told the story. Please note that the word Pharaoh is not a name. It is a title for kingship in Egypt. Just the same way we have Deji of Akure, so also we have Pharaoh of Egypt. May the Lord grant us understanding in the name of Jesus. This is the wisdom of God. Don't sell it.